Shalom to the elect of Israel. This is 2 Maccabees chapter 8. Then Judas Maccabeus and they that were with him went privately into the towns and called their kinsfolk together and took unto them all that just continued in the Jewish religion and assembled about 6,000 men. But let's go real quick into the word for religion here, alright. Yes. Because I actually never, or not really read that in the Bible, right? Okay, so actually we can't look that word up, right? Does it appear somewhere in the so-called New Testament? Yes, alright. So we can actually look it up, right? Try to. So I have my... let's see, maybe I can show it to you, alright? No, let's get it like that. Alright, so let's go to Galatians 1:13. Alright, this is, you know, this is not the best alright, the best book what you want to use here, alright, because it's actually I think it's not even that the Textus Receptus, alright, I think it's some not that best version, alright, I think it's some like the I don't know the name, but you know it's not the Textus, alright. So let's see, 1:13, alright. Here somewhere. Okay, here, okay. So you have heard pretty much, alright, this is German, alright, but you know, see the Greek language above, alright. How you behave yourself, right? In the true, in the true, what is this word in German? Let me look it up, right? You have this German word, right? Real quick, alright, bear with me. Judaism, alright. Actually, it's written here Judaism. But again, alright, this can actually be a wrong translation here, alright, because it's the Nestle, alright, Nestle New Testament, what they always use in theology, right, on the universities, alright. That's the text what they use the most, alright. But this is not the actually correct text, alright. There can be only one manuscript what was actually the real manuscript what they actually used, alright, and this is especially not the Nestle Arlet text, alright, what they, you know, what they call it. It's the Textus Receptus, alright, for, you know, for example, you have verses, alright, that actually, you know, are made up just to pretty much have an excuse to eat swine's flesh, you know, something, you know, some words changed, you know, that it sounds like completely different, right? But you know, even if you would have three sentences that would actually say, alright, you can eat swine's flesh, alright, even that would not make it possible, because the rest of the Bible says, no, you can't, you see? So actually, you know, people just destroyed for a lack of knowledge, alright, or they will be destroyed for a lack of knowledge, right? Because it includes lack of knowledge. According to definition, see. So here, you know, you have heard, alright, of the Judaism, you know, that I'm overdose, you know, pretty much being an agent, alright, to the to the ecclesia, alright? That's the Greek word, you know, the church pretty much, alright? And, you know, and he had pretty much tried to destroy the ecclesia, right? You know, and it goes here into the word again, alright? The word actually is here not religion, alright? But, you know, sometimes they use religion, sometimes they use Judaism, but the actually real word would be actually, as I believe, alright? Look up some other book here, alright? I will show it to you, alright, what the actual word there should be, alright? Because there's always a Bible that actually has the best or the most accurate text, alright? Even when it's German, I can translate it to you, alright? Let's get to it. Right, this is my first Bible, right? Pretty much one of the biggest that I have. You know, it has these gold sides. It's pretty cool, right? Especially at the beginning, you know, it just, you know, feels like, you know, if you read in a Torah and so, you know, it's not that small book, right? So, you know, it's really good to read, pretty much, alright. You see, so this is 1 and 13. So you have heard again, you know, my behavior in the Judaism, right? So the word here is Judaism. He was like a Pharisee, alright? This is Paul writing to the Galatians, alright? And the Galatians were just another church, right? You know, Ecclesia. And he was a Jew from the tribe of Benjamin, because back then they had the correct knowledge of a Jew being just of the southern kingdom, so-called Benjaminites, Levites, and Judites, okay? Not all Israelites are, if you want to keep it exact, are actually Jews, alright? But people don't know that, alright? People don't know anything, alright? So that's why they're pretty much talking BS about the Bible, right? Especially the Amalekites, fake Jews in our land, alright? The heathens in our land, according to the Bible, that had their time, and their time is almost over. You know, they don't understand it also, because they're of course not the real people, especially them. And you know, the word here is Judaism. That means basically that the Pharisee, the Pharisee people, alright? They, you know, they were deep in the laws, right? And they also persecuted pretty much Yehoshua, alright? You know, the priests, alright, the Levites had, you know, mostly to do with this, I believe, alright? But, you know, it's already forgiven to them, right? But actually, you know, they were deep in the law, right, you know, and Yehoshua even were with them, alright, at some point, he was a child, alright, even he was a child. And even in this age, alright, he could actually talk with them like, you know, like he's the teacher, right? You see? So that's what, you know, that's what's up, right? You know. So let's go on. Yehoshua is of the tribe of Judah, alright? So also a Jew, according to the Bible. You see? Which knew me from the beginning, if they would testify that after the most straightest sect of our religion, you see, I lived as a, you know, I lived a Pharisee, you see, a Pharisee, again, he was a Pharisee, alright, and he persecuted, again, the, you know, the followers of Yahushua, and Yahushua, you know, the church of Yahushua. If we go into the word, sect, alright, what is a sect, man? People don't know, alright, people don't know, definition, you know, they just talk BS or white and don't know nothing, man. Alright. Definition of a sect, alright. A dissenting or schismatic religious body, okay? Especially one regarded as extreme or heretical. A religious denomination. Alright, so actually you would say it's a religious body. Because B goes also into a religious denomination, you see, so it's actually just a religious belief, pretty much, right? If we go to the Bible, it has actually history that can be proven, alright? If you go to, let's say you have something like Scientology, you know, or evolution theory believers, alright? You know, they are the extreme ones, alright? They don't even have proof of what they're saying in most cases, alright? They don't even know what they're talking about if they really use the word evolution theory, alright? Because evolution theory has different parts to it, and only one of, I think, five parts is actually real science. And this one part is actually out of the Bible, see? So, you know, people don't know, okay, but they want to play, you know, they want to play cool with you and want to play knowledge with you, right? Let's look at Israelites, for example, you see. For a year I've heard of my conversation in time past in the Jewish religion, how that beyond measure I persecuted the Church of God and wasted it, alright? So religion is not a bad word, alright, to use, you know, but again, alright, we have actually a belief that can be proven, even when we don't see, alright, because, you know, you are glad if you believe and you don't see, alright, because, you know, Yahushua didn't appear unto you, and, you know, in some cases he did, actually, alright, you know, and everybody has his own experience, alright, you know, but it just makes sense, alright, you know, and we are really in a glad time also, alright, because if you are actually not cursed, alright, and you can actually believe what it's written, that's really a blessing, right? Because he will, of course, reward you for that, alright. So he persecuted the Church of Yahweh, right? And profited in the Jewish religion above many, my equals in mine own nation, being more exceedingly zealous of the traditions of my fathers. And, you know, Satanists are actually also religious, you see? So, you know, you have to go by what a word actually means, alright? Satanists are religious, alright? Atheists are religious, alright? So really, every people here is religious. But people who actually don't think, alright, you know, it's like psychological sick people, you know, who actually don't have a doubt, right? Okay? You know, they speak just like, you know, can't say a word, you know. That are actually people, alright, who don't have a religion, okay? James 1, fuck, it's luck. You know, we're still here on this side. Verse 2. And they called upon the Lord that he would look upon the people that was trodden down of oil, and also pity the temple, and profaned of ungodly men, that he would have compassion upon the city so defaced and ready to be made even with the ground, and knew here the blood that cried unto him, and remember the wicked slaughter of harmless infants, and blasphemies committed against his name, and that he would shew his hatred against the wicked. People who actually use the name of Yahweh, Bashem, or Shai, unworthy, or, you know, just to misuse it, alright, will not go unpunished, alright? You can read it in the Torah, alright? And remember the wicked slaughter of harmless, blah, blah. Now when Maccabees had his company about him, he could not be withstood by the heathen, for the wrath of the Lord was turned into mercy. Therefore he came at unawareness, and burnt up towns and cities, and got into his hands in the most commodious place, and overcame and put to flight no small number of his enemies. But specially took he advantage of the night for such private attempts, insomuch that the fruit of his holiness was spread everywhere, So when Philip saw that this man was increased by little and little, and that things prospered with him still more and more, he wrote unto Ptolemais, the governor of Celesyria and Phins, to yield more aid to the king's affairs. Then forthwith choosing Nisanor, the son of Patroclus, one of his special friends, he sent him with no fewer than 20,000 of all nations under him to root out the whole generation of the Jews. And with him he joined also Gorgias, a captain, who in matters of war had great experience. So Nisanor undertook to make so much money of the captive Jews as should defray the tribute of 2,000 talents, which the king was to pay to the Romans. And they're making money today of your ignorance, all right? You know, the fake Jews, especially them, all right? But all the heathens, ultimately. Wherefore, immediately he sent to the cities upon the sea coast, proclaiming a sale of the captive Jews, and promising that they should have 80 bodies for 1 talent, not expecting the vengeance that was to follow up upon him from the Almighty God. Now when word was brought unto Judas of Nisanor's coming, and he had imparted unto those that were with him that the army was at hand, they that were fearful and disputed the justice of God fled and convened themselves away. Others sold all the way all that they had left, and with all besought the Lord to deliver them, sold the wicked Nisanor before they met together. And if not for their own sakes, yet for covenants he had made with their fathers, and for his holy and glorious namesake, by which they were called. So Maccabeus called his men together unto the number of 6,000, and exhorted them not to be stricken with terror of the enemy, not to fear the great multitude of the heathen who came wrongly against them, but to fight manfully, and to set before their eyes the injury that they had unjustly done to the holy place, and the cruel handling of the city, wherefore they made a mockery, and also the taking away of the government of their forefathers. For they, said he, trust in their weapons and boldness, but our confidence is in the Almighty, who at our back can cast down both them that come against us and also all the world. Right. That's what we're actually always saying. Alright, he could actually take down the heathen this day. Alright. But that's not how he wrote the movie, right? Okay. Because the elect are actually already sealed, alright, we believe, so, you know, actually he could actually make an end today, alright. Alright, you know, but you have the microchip in this movie, pretty much being also sealed in the book of his words, alright, you see, you have, and it's already implemented, you see, but you know, you have World War III, okay, and you know, these other things, so, really, you know, just waiting for Armageddon, right, and you know, just some little things, alright, spiritual power, you know, and you know, there are a few things, you know, alright, so it's not much at all, but you know, it's according to the movie, alright, of Yahweh Hashem Yahusha. Moreover, he recounted unto them what helps their forefathers had found, and how they were delivered when under Sennacherib 185,000 perished. And he told them of the battle that they had in Babylon with the Galatians, how they came but 8,000 in all to do the business with 4,000 Macedonians, and that the Macedonians being perplexed, the 8,000 destroyed, and 120,000 because of the help that they had from heaven, and so received a great booty. Thus, when he had made them bold with these words, and ready to die for the law and the country, he divided his army into 4 parts, and joined with himself his own brethren, leaders of each band, 2 with Simon and Joseph and Jonathan, giving each of 1,500 men. Also he appointed Eleazar to read the holy book, and when he had given them this watchword, the help of God, Yahweh Shemesh himself, leading the first band, and by the help of the Almighty, they slew about 9,000 of their enemies, and rounded and maimed the most part of Nisanor's host, and so put all to flight, and took their money that came to buy them, and pursued them far, but lacking time they returned. For it was the day before the Sabbath, and therefore they would no longer pursue them. So when they had gathered their armor together and spoiled their enemies, they all prepared themselves about the Sabbath, yielding exceeding grace and thanks to the Lord who had preserved them into the day, unto that day, which was the beginning of mercy distilling upon them. And after the Sabbath, when they had given part of the spoils to the maimed and to the widows and orphans, the residue they divided among themselves and their servants. When this was done and they had made a common supplication, they besought the merciful Lord to be reconciled with his servants forever. Moreover, of those that were with Timotheus and Barbidus who fought against them, they slew above 20,000 and very easily got high in strongholds, and divided among themselves many spoils more, and made the maimed, orphans, widows here, and the aged also equals in spoils with themselves, alright. In this last time, then, we have Israelites, alright, destroying 1,000 people, man, alright, one against 1,000, man, alright, so this is nothing to compare with, alright, this last time, alright, you know, it's just heavy, man, alright. I have this one, you know, we don't trust too much in dreams or in visions, alright, but, you know, saw this one video from the brother, alright, and he just, you know, saw, he was with his wife and with his child. There came like two Archaeon from the camp, alright, and this one, you know, he just said, you know, and actually his wife had this dream, alright, I think it was not him, alright, his wife had this dream. Watch on my overview site on my channel, and you will see the video, alright, on the lowest part of the site, alright, and you will see the video. And she had the dream that this one brother, alright, this one arc, he actually just looked like, you know, like you see it in Dragon Ball Z, alright, funny man, alright, you know, some Archaeon coming to you, right, in that kind of power, right, that's, you know, that's really also honor, man, alright, you know, it's not just honor, you know, to die for the Lord, alright, it's also honor, right, to receive that spiritual power, because actually, you know, he don't give anybody spiritual power, alright, you know, any Israelite can't receive spiritual power, okay, any Israelite can't even come to the point where he receives spiritual power, alright, you know, so there's an honor to everything, but all the honor, alright, and glory belongs to Yahweh, Hashem, Yahweh Shai, and him only, alright, ultimately, alright, we have no honor, ultimately we have no glory, alright, because he will not let his glory be taken to some other, alright, especially not humans, okay, and angels, you know. We are gods, of course, alright, and you know, and just this, pretty much this, you know, he can use them, alright. You know. The sons of God, right, the angels, okay. Even Satan was called as a son of God, alright, if you read that Job, alright. But we will be pretty much above the angels, okay? So just keep that in mind, okay? That, you know, the angels desire to look into what we pretty much preaching here, alright? Because we have the 144% truth, alright? So really, you know, be aware of something, alright? When it comes to spiritual power, alright? Of, you know, pretty much being surprised, alright? By the power, alright? That Yahweh Hashem Yahweh Shai can reveal to his prophets, especially the prophets, alright, and then to his few chosen, okay, but especially the prophets again, okay, and I can only repeat what Apostle Thomas said, alright, if you call yourself a prophet, alright, I just repeat it, like he said it, alright, at least, you know, you should do one video a day, at least, alright, you know, let's say you didn't make one a day, you know, you do actually two the next day, alright, and, you know, at least for the brothers who are in camps and so on, alright, they're what's on the street, I guess, not everyone, but, you know, at least I would say, like, He said, actually, alright, 10 minutes, at least 3 videos a week, okay? That's the official order from coming down from the elders and apostles of Good Minister. Okay. You know, and you know, we have not a power of, you know, being pretty much, you know, not really merciful unto us or something, alright? Of course, he will see what you do, alright? He will see what your situation is and all of that, man, alright? So don't be over much given into, you know, stress or something, alright? If you say, like, oh, okay, so, you know, I did not a video this day or something, you know, or, you know, can't reach the camp or whatever it is, man, alright? Just make sure that you do the laboring, alright? And, you know, do it, and you will get reward for it, okay? But if you say in your heart, alright, you know, I will oppress the spirit pretty much, alright, when the spirit is on you, something like that, alright, that's not good, man. And if you have that doubt, man, cut it out, alright, otherwise you will be punished, alright, because the blood will be on your hands, right, if you don't do this with all heart, mind, alright, and all, with all, what is it, soul, alright, soul, heart, and, with all your heart, all your mind, and all your soul, alright, that's the three, I think the three in the Ten Commandments, right? You can always use that, right? But with all your heart, all your mind, and all your soul, right? You know, that's the most important, alright? Not that you know more than me, okay? So there's an official, you know, this has to be done, alright, but you know what I mean, okay? Verse 31. And when they had gathered their armor together, they laid them up, all carefully in convenient places, and the remnant of the spoils they brought to Jerusalem. They slew also Pilarches, alright? That wicked person who was with Timotheus and had anointed the Jews many ways. Furthermore, at such time as they kept the feast for the victory in their country, they burned Callisthenes, alright, that had set fire upon the holy gates, who had fled into a little house, and so he received a reward meet for his wickedness. As for that most ungracious Nisanor, who had brought 1,000 merchants to buy the Jews, he was to the help of the Lord, brought down by them, of whom he made least account, and putting off his glorious apparel and discharging his company, he made like a fugitive servant to the Midland unto Antioch, having great, very great dishonor, for that his host was destroyed. Thus he that took upon him to make good to the Romans that tribute by means of captives in Jerusalem told abroad that the Jews had God to fight for them, and therefore they could not be hurt, because they followed the laws that he gave them. Alright, again, if you keep the laws, you will be protected. If you're not keeping the laws that are actually good to you and even not difficult, okay, you will not be protected, it says to you. That's just the truth, man. And the last two sentences, alright, they're actually from the Bible, okay? Laws are not difficult, alright? If you don't keep the laws, you will not be protected. If you keep the laws, you will be protected, okay? It's that easy. About the time came Antiochus with dishonor out of the country of Persia, for he had entered the city called Persepolis, and went about to rob the temple and to hold the city, whereupon the multitude, wanting to defend themselves with their weapons, put them to flight. And so it happened that Antiochus, being put to flight of the inhabitants, returned with shame. Now when he came to Ecbatana, news was brought to him what had happened unto Nisanor and Timotheus. Then swelling with anger, he thought to avenge upon the Jews the disgrace done unto him by those that that made him flee. Therefore commanded he his chariot men to drive without ceasing, and to dispatch the judgment of God now following him, for he had spoken boldly in the sword that he would come to Jerusalem and made it a common burying place of the Jews. Alright, again for the word God that is used here is actually the word Yahweh, alright? You know? And Lord is... was it that way? I think God is Yahweh actually, and Lord is the word being used in this Bible, Anachayim, alright? In Paleo-Hebrew also, alright? Anachayim, okay? In the Jewish, fake Jew Hebrew, you would say Elohim, alright? In Paleo-Hebrew, it pretty much means the same, but it's Anachayim, okay? Verse 5. But the Lord Almighty, the God of Israel, smote him with an incurable and invisible plague, for as soon as he had spoken these words, a pain of the bowels that were remediless came upon him, and saw torments of the inner parts. Yeah, but let's check this real quick. Ah, no, okay, so actually it's Yahweh for Lord, alright, you see, so that actually makes sense, alright, because the so-called New Testament uses a God, alright, mostly, so actually you have like Yod Hey Vav Hey, alright, Yahweh, of course with the vocals here, for Lord, alright, Lord is always being used in the so-called Old Testament. It's one Bible, alright, there is no Old and New Testament, alright, that was a hedonistic traditional way to furthermore, alright, confuse the people, alright, they that are actually cursed out to be confused, alright, okay, and for God you have the word, just God or something, alright, but Lord is actually Yahweh, alright, let's get it real quick. Because this has no Greek, I think, no Greek, Anahayim, alright, God, Anahayim, okay, so it's Anahayim, right, the Hebrew word here, so, Genesis, it's the so-called Old Testament, Asalak, so God is Anahayim, and Lord is Yahweh, alright? Because Anahayim is just like Yahweh, but in a plural, alright? So it can be Yahweh Shai, it can be an angel, alright? It can be pretty much been everything, alright? You know, if you read something like God did this, alright? It can be an angel also. But if you read like Yahweh, alright, you know that it's Yahweh, alright? Okay? You know, the one and only power, and he has no God besides him, alright? See, so if you read like, and Noah built an altar unto the Lord, you see, the word would be here for Yahweh, and took of every clean beast, and of every clean fowl, and offered burnt offerings unto the altar. You know, it's just the better version, alright, of it's the better version, alright, of the Hebrew, alright. See, so you can go by Anahayim, alright, and Yahweh, alright. You know, just imagine, alright, our people speaking the name, alright. They would say, like, you know, we have some Indians, for example, alright. And even if you go into the Bantu languages. Alright, special. There are actually special languages there that that have actually a really close connection, alright, to the national Holy Tongue. Alright, and if you say like Yahweh, alright, you will see that it actually makes sense, alright, because nobody would speak some fake Jew language, especially not back then. Alright, today you have heathens, you know, thinking that this is actually a language. Alright, but you know, again, especially in ancient times, they would not. Talk or write in Masoretic Hebrew or something, okay? Verse 6. ended most justly, for he had tormented other men's bowels with many and strange torments. Howbeit he nothing at all ceased from his bragging, but still was filled with pride, breathing out fire in his rage against the Jews, and commanding to haste the journey. But it came to pass that he fell down from his chariot, carried violently, so that having a sore fall, all the members of his body were much pained. And thus he that a little afore thought he might command the waves of the sea, so proud was he beyond the condition of man, and weighed the high mountains in a balance, was now cast on the ground, and carried in a horse litter, shearing forth unto all the manifest power of Yahweh, or Allahayim in this case, right? So that the worms rose up out of the body of this wicked man, and whilst he lived in sorrow and pain, his flesh fell away, and the filthiness of his smell was noisome to all his army. I'll show you something real quick while we're at the topic pretty much, right? This is actually interesting, right? You know, sometimes I speak a little bit more, right? But I try to speak as less as possible, you know, around the verses that we read. But if some people watch the playlist actually to 2 Maccabees or 1 Maccabees, alright, it's actually interesting in some cases to actually have this information. So, you know, I try to keep it as less as possible, right? Lord from heaven. You know, just skip it, you know, or something, you know, if you don't like it. I don't really care, but you know. Check this, man. Alright, Genesis 19:24. Right. Check this. Then the Lord, alright, the word being used here, Yahweh, okay. Then the Lord rained upon Sodom and Gomorrah, Sodom and upon Gomorrah, brimstone and fire from the Lord, right, from the Lord out of heaven. See, so Yahweh rains down brimstone from Yahweh out of heaven. Okay. Okay. Some of you may know this, okay? So what means that? You see? What that means is actually, you know, it's just Yahweh, right? It's just one power, right? One power, okay? And if we go to the word, to the verse here, pretty much you can see. From itself, from the self-existent or eternal, right? So Yahweh, the existing one. You know, some description here. Yahweh, okay. And here you have also Yahweh, right? So Yahweh went upon Sodom and Gomorrah, upon Sodom and upon Gomorrah, brimstone and fire from Yahweh. The Yahweh out of heaven, something like that, I believe, even okay. So, the Lord Yahweh, pretty much, all right, pretty much is the one who does these things, all right. He's also the, you know, just check that information on my laptop. Yeah. He is the, pretty much the creator of darkness and light, all right. And there is no God specific. No God besides Yahweh, alright? But you have Yahweh Shai, being the only begotten son of Yahweh Baal Shem Yahweh Shai, alright? And he is prophesied in the whole scriptures, okay? If you can receive it, alright? And he is over King David pretty much, alright? And we are pretty much under King David and under Yahweh Shai, alright? And Yahweh is, you know, unspeakable great power, all right? And he is doing things, all right, to his servants and prophets, all right? But again, especially to Yahweh Shai, all right? So it can actually be being Yahweh Shai here, all right, raining brimstone down, you know, something like that, you know. Basically, the point is, it went down, okay? And it's all You know, it's all in the Ten Commandments, man. All right, you should have no God, you know, before me or something. Or, you know, not beside me. All right, that's important. All right, that's important. Second Maccabees, and you know, if you're a Levite, all right, just remember, all right, if you once spoke against Yahushua, it will be forgiven to you, all right. But you know, even if you once didn't, you know, when there was a time where you didn't believe in him, all right, it's forgiven, all right. But you know, hold fast, all right, because you know it's important. Okay. You know, again, I believe that we were the priests, the wicked priests, all right, that actually were, you know, pretty much the killers of Yahawashai, pretty much, right? Pharisees, you know, and so on, and you know. Okay, so don't take it, you know, again, give not your mind over to heaviness, all right? You know. Okay. It's just in your, you know, you are a Levite, man, all right? So, you know, make sure you believe in Yahawashai, all right? And you know, to him you can actually have, you know, be partaker of Yahweh. Okay, that's just what it is. Okay, and he will show himself, all right, to the Levites in the latter end, all right, and then you will see, all right, that you know, there's one truth, okay, and you know, there's one God, all right, and we had to learn it, man, all right. You know, we had to learn it. This is verse 10. And the man that thought a little afore he could reach to the stars of heaven, no man could endure to carry for his intolerable stink. He therefore, being plagued, he began to leave of his great pride, and to come to the knowledge of himself by the sword of God, his pain increasing every moment. And when he himself could not abide his own smell, he said these words, "It is meet to be subject unto God, and that a man that is mortal should not proudly think of himself as if he were Allahayim." This wicked person vowed also unto Yahweh, who now no more would have mercy upon him, saying thus, that the holy city to the which he was going in haste to lay it even with the ground, and to make it a common burying place, he would set them at liberty. And as touching the Jews, whom he had judged not worthy so much as to be buried, but to cast out with their children to be devoured of the fowls and wild beasts, he would make them all equals to the citizens of Athens, or Athens, or how you say. And the holy temple, which before he had spoiled, he would garnish with godly gifts and restore all the holy vessels with any more. And out of his own revenue, defray the charges belonging to the sacrifices. Yeah, and that also he would become a Jew himself and go to all the world that was inhabited and declare the power of Allahayim. Allahayim is a luck. No, you don't say the ch too much, alright? You have the kha, alright, the letter kha in the Lashon Kodesh, alright? But you don't say it that much like you do it in the fake Jew Hebrew, alright? In the Masoretic Hebrew, for example, all right, because they invented also many, you know, many things in that language, all right, and you know, came down from other languages also, it's a little bit mixed also, you know, and all the stuff, all right, it's not a pure language, okay, so we don't use that at all that much, all right, you know, and if you say Allahayim, all right, you say like Allahayim, all right, you don't say Allahayim. Okay. Let's get it real quick. Yeah, I believe it's kind of high now. Yes, it's Allahayim, alright, it's not Allahayim, okay? No, just to make sure that not nice, but you know, speaking something that's not weird. you know, No, I'm just learning the Lashwankadash, right? I'm not, you know, that good at all at the moment, but, you know, I get better, you know. And, you know, I'm not good at languages, but, you know, it's just our nature to speak that language, and we will speak it perfect in the kingdom. Alright? Really perfect, alright? And, you know, other languages also, because we have it in our mind. But for all this, his pains would not cease. For the just judgment of Alahayim was come upon him. Therefore, the sparing of his healed, he wrote unto the Jews the letter on the written, containing the form of a supplication after this manner. Antiochus, king of and governor to the good Jews, his citizens, wished much joy, health, and prosperity. If ye and your children were farewell, and your affairs be to your contentment, I give very great thanks to Alahayim, having my hope in heaven. As for me, I was weak, or else I would have remembered kindly your honor and good will returning out of Persia. Persia is the modern day Iraq or Iran, alright, some of them too, alright. And being taken with a curious disease, I thought it necessary to care for the common safety of all. Not distrusting mine health, but having great hope to escape the sickness. But considering that you can even, take that for the modern time, alright, he will not put a coronavirus on you, alright. If you take the vaccine, he would, you know, it's just, you deserved it, alright, if you take the vaccine, because the vaccine actually makes you sick. Okay. Okay. You know, but if you're an Israelite and you keep the commandments, he will not put some coronavirus on you, alright, or some other disease, alright, because they are actually more than that, alright. And also, no weapon that is found against you will prosper, alright. You have this 5G all over the place, even in America, alright. And you know, they used their time where people were in their houses, alright, while this coronavirus, you see, and they placed 5G towers even over there in America, alright. And, you know, it pretty much can prosper against you because, you know, you're protected again, alright. Yahweh controls everything, okay? You know, this is not a power to play with, okay? He can use everything to kill you, alright? Even weapons that are actually from Esau Edom, so-called white man, woman, and child. 9:22. But considering that even my father, at what time he had led an army into the high countries, appointed us a chaser, to the end that if anything fell out contrary to expectation, or if any tidings were brought that were grievous, they of the land, knowing to whom the state was left, might not be troubled. Again, considering how that the princes that are borderers of night and nightbirds, so I have to drink. And expect what shall be the event. I have appointed my son Antiochus king, whom I often committed and commanded unto many of you, when I went up into the high provinces, to whom I have written as followed. Therefore I pray and request you to remember the benefits that I have done unto you generally, and in special, and that every man will be still faithful to me and my son. For I am persuaded that he, understanding in my mind, will favorably and curiously yield to your desires. Thus the murderer and blasphemer, having suffered most grievously as he entered other men, so died he a miserable death in a strange country in the mountains. You see? And Philip, that was brought up with him, carried away his body, who also fearing the son of Antiochus went into Egypt to Ptolemy's Philometor, alright, and that goes for the blasphemers, agents, and, you know, scorners, okay? You will reap, ultimately, you will get, alright, you know, what you deserve, okay? And if you're an Israelite, alright, the truth, you know, be pretty much faithful unto death, you will receive your heart's desires, right? So, you know, you can choose, okay? Because if I say heathen, alright, I also mean the heathen Israelites. Okay, because they are heathens according to the Bible. If they are far from the truth, right? You see? And you know, everyone will get what he deserves, okay? And you can't go around that, alright? And that's righteous, and you know, that's Anachayim, right? The power and, you know, the powers, right? The B, okay. Knowing with that, all praises to Yahweh Hashem, Maroshai. Alright, Lord willing, we'll see us in the next books, right, pretty much. Alright. Shalom.